The stage is set for yet another turf war as the ground shifts for Kenya's alcoholic beverages market. East African Breweries Limited, which has maintained a near monopoly of Kenya's beer market, has signaled its readiness to protect its turf with the high-profile repacking of the Tusker Lager beer. Speaking when he unveiled the new look Tusker, EABL's managing director Sheni Adetu hinted at the move being a signal of the impending fierce competition, with speculation rife that once back in the market, SAB Miller and Pepsi Cola will target both the alcoholic and non-alcoholic drinks operations of the company.
We believe that competition is good, genuinely we do, and if it's good competition in the sense that everybody plays the game well and the playing field is level, it would normally serve to expand the category.
SAB Miller will be returning to the Kenyan market as owner of Crown Foods, bottlers of Keringet Water, and has already entered a franchising deal with Coca-Cola to bottle and distribute some of its brands. The 1 billion shilling investment in Tusker, a brand that has enjoyed unrivaled success since its introduction in 1922, comes at a time when the brewer is facing a threat to its margins due to high production costs driven by expensive fuel and raw material, as well as tighter restrictions on alcohol consumption.
I do believe that ultimately legitimate businesses like ours will benefit from it. But when is that ultimate timing is, I think, is the issue. Because what we do know right now is that those same illicits that this law was intended to prevent or curtail in growth have continued to actually expand beyond the pre-act situation.
The high cost of living, which recently saw prices of certain brands of beer shoot up by between 5 to 10 shillings, have also not helped the situation, but EABL remains bullish that a growing middle class will continue to support its bottom line.
For the 89 years it's been in the market, Tusker has managed to beat off competition and stay ahead of its game. But with emerging challenges such as high production costs, renewed competition, and now an economy that makes alcohol consumption a luxury, does EABL see any opportunities in the Kenyan market?
Irrespective of what is happening in the economy, there's always an inherent headroom for growth in our business. So, for example, do we have Tusker in every bar that we should have it? Maybe not. So there's an opportunity with distribution.
Wanjiro Gaitho, Citizen Business.